$1,800 a box in 1850. $1,850 a box in 1900 a box in 1950. $1,900 a box in 1950. $1,950 a box in 2000. $2,000 a box in 2100. $2,000 a box in 2100. 2100. 2100 is box in 2200 a box in 23. 2200 a box in 23. 2200 a box, 2300 a box, and 2400 and 25. 25. 2400 a box, 25. 2400, 2500 a box, and 2600 a box, and 27. 2600 a box, and 27. 2700 a box, and 28. 2800 a box, and 29. 2800 a box, and 29. 2900 a box, and 3000 a box, and 3100. 3000 a box, and 3100. 3,100 a box and 3,200. 3,200 a box and 33. 3,300 a box and 3,400 a box and 35. 3,400 a box, 3,500 a box and 36. 3,600 a box and 37. 3,700 a box and 38. 3,800 a box and 39. 3,900 a box and 4,000. 3,900 a box and 4,000. Are you all done at 3,900 a box? Yes or no? Gone 3,900 box, 1166. Which one do you want? Let them choose.
All right, now we're rolling. Okay, Chris, so you were the auctioneer for this giant pen auction that just happened today. What happened today, and did you expect it when these pens came into Orrill's auction house?
Well, I expected them to sell well, but not that well. Then again, I haven't seen a collection like that ever. Last batch we had that sold well was just one single box of probably about 30 or 40 fountain in ballpoint pens that had a lot of age to them. This set had a lot of age, but
this was 11 boxes.
12 boxes, actually.
12 boxes.
And they were all over the place in terms of age. I know there had to be some in there that had to be over 100 years old.
Oh, yeah. There were at least some from the late 19th century.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's just, you don't see them in bulk like that. Yeah. And we still have half of a banker's box full of these pens to display in the flat box is the way that we displayed these. And so hopefully the second batch will be even better, but there's no guarantee. Because like I said, we're not pen experts. We just try and get the right customers here. We advertise about it and tell about it so that we can get the customers here who want to buy it. And, we give them the time to preview so that they can, make an informed decision rather than just, throwing pens out in front of them and saying, hey, make up your mind now. And that's hopefully what helped. Because I know a couple of the guys that went really high today on the pricing, they spent a lot of time here yesterday previewing, writing down, taking notes, and so forth. So,
what's it like when you're an auctioneer and something like that happens, where just there's a spirited bidding and two people are just not going to...
It makes my job easy. It's fun. That's what we want. The things that are hard to sell, are frustrating to sell because you can't get a patter going. With bidding like that, it keeps everybody's attention. And when everybody's attention is there, it's on the stuff. It's not on the auctioneer. It's not on the bidders. It's on what are they bidding on? And it brought all the attention to the pens.
So when's the second half of this pen, of this amazing pen collection, going to be auctioned at Orrill's?
December 8th.
December 8th, 2015.
Yes, Tuesday, December 8th. And it'll be coming up after 1:30 in the afternoon at our location here in Sunland.
And people can bid via phone or...
They can leave absentee bids. They can have phone bids. If they do an absentee or a phone bid, they need to pay immediately after the bidding stops on those items that they bid on.
By credit card over the phone?
By credit
right
card
away.
Over the phone.
Okay.
Or if they want to leave cash with us, which can be refunded to them should they not. Because it does save them money on the buyer's premium if they pay their bill in its entirety in cash.
Right.
But the reason we require that payment on a phone bid, especially if we don't know them, is so that if they don't pay right away, we find out right away and we can reoffer it so the back bidders have another chance at them rather than... But, once they bid, they need to pay.
Thank you. Congratulations on today. And we'll be back on December 8th to see what happens with part two.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you.